Hi everybody, I think every one of us heard of catastrophic deforestation on the planet. Do trees remain for 300 years? What will we breathe when they are over? The first disaster in the forest, not the sun? How is the world going to deal with the problem of logging, and what are conservationists doing to do it? The education company will try to answer these questions. Ready? Then let's go. Apart from various climate paradoxes, warming, depletion of natural sources of clean water and many other factors, this is no less important among them, deforestation. And the catastrophic, disorderly and wildly growing trend of thinning makes you think, really, in 300 years there will not a single tree on the planet. Not so long ago, scientists at Yale University created a detailed map of density of the Earth's forests and estimated that our planet grows about 3 trillion years. They provide us with oxygen, soften the climate and make the Earth a beautiful place to live. Before the development of human civilization, there were about 6 trillion trees. Therefore, people have already cut down half the trees. Every year, another 10 to 14 billion are cut down according to various data. At this rate, in 300 years, we will have no forest at all. In the first second you may not notice anything, but in big city it will suddenly become louder, because the trees absorb noise as the acoustic filters. Sounds good. Reflected from the hard surfaces of walls and roads, but porous soft leaves absorb them. A strip of trees 30 meters wide can reduce the noise level from road by 5 to 10 decibels. That is almost 10 times. It can be noted that suffocate immediately. First, trees produce only 30% of all oxygen. Most of them are marine organisms, algae and phytoplankton. Secondly, now in the atmosphere of the Earth about 21% of oxygen, and the person needs to breathe at least 17%. Before we exhale the entire supply of oxygen, it will take about 200 years. But let's not forget that trees clean the air every day as a filter 30%. There are no trees, therefore there is no filter. So we think 200 years is a very high figure. After the disappearance of trees, we will begin to notice frequent flooding. Trees absorb huge amounts of moisture during heavy rains. This will be followed by rapid soil erosion. The rapid flow of the large amounts of land into rivers and lakes will lead to the flowering of water and the death of many aquatic animals and plants. At the same time, the forest is one of the cheapest sources of the natural resources. Every minute, 20 hectares of forest territories are destroyed, and humanity should now think about replenishing these natural resources. Learn how to properly manage forest management and the wonderful ability of the forest to self-renew. If you agree with us, then put a like under this video, so that as many people as possible aware of the imperceptibly impending disaster. What shall we do? Forest protection policies may differ significantly from country to country. Someone introduces a restriction on the use, and someone just increases the volume of recovery landings. But a completely new approach to this problem has developed Norway. She completely refused to cut down. This country has officially announced that its territory will implement a policy of so-called zero deforestation. Over the years, Norway has actively supported various forest protection programs. For example, in 2015, it allocated 1 billion rubles to preserve the Amazon rainforest. Investments by Norway and a number of other countries. And a number of other countries have helped to reduce the amount of logging by 75%. From 2011 to 2015, the Norwegian government allocated 250 billion rubles to another tropical country, Guyana. And since 2017, Norway has officially declared zero tolerance for logging. This is, it will no longer buy forest products. Experts in the field ecology claim that the paper can be produced by recycling the relevant waste, and other resources can be used as a fuel and building materials. According to the wildlife found, every minute from the surface of the Earth disappear forest area comparable to the area of 48 football fields. It also significantly increases the emission of greenhouse gases that contribute to global warming. Due to deforestation in the wild, are dying of valuable year of valuable forest rare species of animals. To save their reindeer population from extinction, several million hectares of forest must be preserved intact. Improper logging undermines even fish stocks. When deforestation in the river washed away clay and dead organic matter, sedimentary mud can destroy the eggs, the most valuable and rare fish. For example, salmon caviar must be washed with clean and oxygen-rich water, otherwise it dies. It is possible to cut down valuable wood pieces as a result of violation of integrity of systems. A bug beetle can get into the wood and destroy all remaining territory. Greenpeace stands for the preservation of valuable wild forests and the eradication of the causes that lead to their destruction. They also advocate changing the quality of forestry, creating and protecting specially protected natural areas, solving the problem of forest fires. There are places that could become zoos, territories where the forest is ground for the needs for people. If proper forestry is established in these abandoned forests, it can provide hundreds of thousands of new jobs and income needed for the socio-economic development of rural areas of the country. Greenpeace advocates that these forests be legalized and that abandoned areas are primarily used for productive forestry. This requires first and foremost competent forest and land laws regulations. By the way, about the amount of territory for planting new forests. Recently, an Australian think tank announced that trees should be planted because of the approaching global warming, which could kill humanity by 2050. To somehow slow down the process of global temperature rise, people need to plant 1 billion hectares of forest on Earth. But is there enough space on the planet for the growth of so many trees? Researchers from the Swiss Higher Technical School, Zurich, are confident that enough is enough. There are 900 billion hectares of free space on the planet, which can be compared to the area of the United States. Calculations have shown that at the moment 900 billion hectares of free space are available for planting forests. The largest number of trees can be planted in 6 countries: Russia, USA, Canada, Brazil, Australia, and China. In particular, Russia can grow 151 million hectares of the forest. Do you think humanity will be able to correctly prioritize the failing of planting of trees? Or will we be breathing artificial oxygen preparations in a few hundred years? Leave your answers in the comments. We hope you liked this video and you were able to learn something new for yourself. Subscribe to our channel and put like and bell for not to miss the next video.